Hello, welcome back. Today we are going to learn about flashpoint and firepoint. Flashpoint. What is a flashpoint? And first of all, basically, where these will be used? The flashpoint and the firepoint are useful to measure the oil usage of any engine. Right? What is the purpose? For a lubricant, what are the nature of flash point and fire point? How to measure the flash point? Today we are going to learn. Coming to the flash point. Flash point, the lowest temperature at which the vapors of an oil catches moment of flash. Right, the vapors of the oil catches momentary flash. Mean to say, the oil will convert into the vapor, and when a test flame was passed, it just catches the fire for a moment, right, for a fraction of second. Then that temperature is known as flash point temperature. Then what is the fire point? The lowest temperature at which the oil catches the fire, when the fire is passed, right, or test fire is passed, then at least the flame should continue for at least 5 seconds, then it is known as fire point. So if the flame is continued for the 5 seconds at least, then we have to call it as fire point. And a moment of flash, if we observe that temperature, we should call it as flash point. Now, how to determine the flash point? There is an apparatus called as Penske-Martin's apparatus. What is the apparatus? Penske-Martin's apparatus. Flash point apparatus. So, by using Penske-Martin's flash point apparatus, we can able to measure the flash point of the oil, whatever it is, the lubricant, you can say. So, what an apparatus consists of? Basically, it consists of a cup, right? And the measurement of this cup will be, in the width it is 5 centimeters and in depth it is 5.5 centimeters. So what is the width I am saying to you? 5 centimeters and depth will be 5.5 centimeters. Clear? And this is made up of brass. What is the material made? Made up of brass, and it will have a shutter. You know, the shutter is nothing but a cap like used to be closed, right? It is having a shutter. It will have 4 openings. So one for placing the thermometer, where you can able to put the thermometer to measure the temperature, right? One more is there for the placing of stirrer, right? This stirrer is having blades so that it will move clearly and neatly. A equal temperature will be maintained, and the stirrer will be arranged like this. So it is having a cap over here to ease of holding, and then it will have a pilot frame or test oil frame over here along with the burner. Here a small opening will be there where the vapors are going to come out, right? How the vapors, when the oil is present, the vapors are going to amount. Therefore, the burner will present over here, which is helpful for giving the flame. Along with this, you are having a testoid flame, which is to be carried out like this. And along with this, you are having the apparatus will be like this. And in this, the oil is present. It will be having air bath. Right? The air bath will be holding the apparatus or your cup properly. So, overall, this will be included to a stand. Right? And a flame, for the flame, a burner will be there. Right, so burner is going to give the flame. So what are these, what we are having? This is the stirrer. This is a thermometer. And you are having air bath. And this is, what is this I said to you? Pilot burner. And here you are having test oil fire. So the fire is going to come over here. So what you are having over here? Test flame. Next, actually test oil flame, exactly speaking. And now what happens, how it works? So the apparatus, what we can observe here, a cup which can hold the oil, and it is arranged with the air bath. Air bath is going to hold this cup properly. It is placed on a stand. Burner is useful for the giving the fire, the temperature, and stirrer helpful for stirring, and the thermometer helpful for measuring the temperature. Now, the width of this cup will be 5 cm width and depth will be 5.5 cm. And this cup will have a groove over here till where you have to fill the oil. So, when the oil was filled up to the mark and then heating will be started, for every 1 degree raise in temperature, what I said, every 1 degree centigrade raise in the temperature, they are going to measure the they are going to test by the burner whether the vapors are came or flash point came. As the oil heats up, the raise in the temperature changes 1 degree centigrade, it will be checked for its flash point by using the pilot burner. If the flame is not going to come or it is not going to give moment of a flash, then the heating will be continued. While heating, to maintain the temperature properly, because at the bottom the oil is heating more and at the top it will be cool. To avoid that, the stirrer will be used and therefore the oil is going to be, or heat is dispersed overall equally. So the temperature will be noted down from time to time, and the at a certain moment of time, for example, if you have taken kerosene, its flash point is 73 degrees Fahrenheit. Okay, so at that moment it gives a flash, so that the temperature will be noted down as a flash point. Then still more further it will be included. How to measure? Actually, this is a shutter I said. So this will be operated with the help of a lever, right? And whenever this is there, it can be helpful for closing of the this shutter. And this is known as shutter control. closing and opening of this cap. If the vapors are not coming, again they are going to close this and heating will be continued along with the stirring until and unless the fire will catch for a flash of the moment. Then if the flash comes, the temperature will be noted down. If the flash comes, what I said, the temperature will be noted down. Then again they will close the shutter and heating will be continued till furthermore we can able to get the flash point. Then how to get the flash point? I said to you, at least the fire should continue for minimum 5 seconds, I said, right? Till the vapors. So to continue the fire for 5 seconds, it needs more amount of vapors. Therefore, it needs high temperature. So the heating will be continued until the vapors whatever released from this point are going to catch the fire and retain for 5 seconds. Then the temperature will be noted down. Clear? That point is known as fire point. So what is the apparatus we are using to measure the fire point? The fire point will be measured by Penske Martin's flash point apparatus. This is the apparatus. One more we can able to measure, because these comes under the, it is very important for lubricants. For a good lubricant, always the flash point and fire point should be more than the engine working temperature. Then only it can able to maintain properly the engine. Clear? And if it is less than the engine working temperature, what happens? It catches the fire. As it is the lubricant, automatically it catches the fire and accident happens. You see, and though so many times you observe that in the news, the cars are firing on the road in between the, on the way, the car gets fired itself. The reason is not using a proper lubricant oil. Because if the lubricant oil temperature is low, then it catches the fire. Because of the temperature that was produced by the engine, it catches the fire. And next, why it is important that much? Why we have to consider the flash point? If the flash point of the oil is more, the oil consumption of the or petrol or diesel consumption of the engine will be less. Clear? That is the reason why it is not a benchmark, but it helps in one of the way. Next one. Apart from this flash point and fire point, we can able to concentrate on the remaining properties of the lubricants. The remaining properties of the lubricants. What are the remaining properties? Cloud point and pore point. What is a cloud point or pore point? Actually, the cloud point is the temperature at which a cloudiness in the oil we can able to observe. What is this cloudiness? Mean to say, if you observe the oil, just take the coconut oil. When you are observing the coconut oil, when it is, the temperature was low in the winter, what happens? It tries to convert into solid. It becomes a solidified. Before solidifying, the oil will not be clear. It appears as meshy, cloudy. So the temperature at which the cloudiness appears or the cleanness disappears, it is called as cloud point, right? And this is because of, why this cloud point comes or why this cloudiness comes? This is because of the presence of, you can say, paraffin-like items in the oil, right? And because of this, they are going to solidify at the low temperatures. If you observe, for any oil, the cloud point should be less, because the engine should work in the colder region also, If the lubricant or the oil will have high cloud point, it is going to come, or the oil is going to solidify very fast. To avoid that, the cloud point should be very very less. Clear? Today what we learned? Flash point, fire point, and how to measure the flash point, and what is a cloud point. Thank you very much, and let us meet in the next session with another topic. Have a nice day. Thank you.